I did play the game together with my mom and dad, and yes, they freak out if they see a game controller, right? So I just could give them their own phones. They could just play it on their own phones, and it worked fine, and we played the story together. I'm Ron the Feijter, technical director of Interior Night, and we've just delivered our first game, As Dusk Falls. As Dusk Falls is a narrative game, or an interactive drama, as some people call it. It's about these two families who have their life entangled. And it all centers around an event where there's a hostage situation, basically. And those two families are on the different sides of the hostage situation.
Hey.
Hey. You. You doing okay?
Yeah.
Every choice you make is valid, right? It's not like a detective game where you either uncover the culprit or not. It's every choice leads to a valid outcome.
Hey, hey.
This game is not about skill in terms of button combinations, exact timings of your button presses, feeling comfortable with the controller, right? It's all about the characters and the story and the choices you make. It's more like life skills, right? What choice do you make in this situation?
Sorry to lock you up like this.
We wanted to make it accessible as possible, and that's why we have a companion app. So the game still plays on screen, but you use the phone to do the interactions, to control a cursor on screen, to make your choices or to do QTEs by swiping. So you don't ever have to look at the phone. You just look at the main screen. Of course, when you start looking at xCloud, that even makes the next step possible, right? That you actually play the game on your phone and have touch directly on the phone. So that makes it even more accessible. You see a button, you can just press on it, right? It says swipe, you swipe. It just only requires you to do the things that you're already used to doing when you use your phone.
All right, but only a half hour.
Yay!
In everything we do, basically, the story is key. It's all about the story. And it was all about getting those nuanced facial expressions that only real actors have. That's all to make the story shine, basically. And that's the same for the interactions, right? We don't want people to have to think about the interaction they have to do. You can just pick up your phone, you open the app, and you can interact in the way that you're used to interacting using your phone with things. That's been like the underlying requirement for everything we do. Just make it accessible and straightforward for people to use. When we started the game, we weren't really considering xCloud at all. Only when Microsoft got involved as our publisher, did we start talking to them about this and start thinking about this. We use xCloud to play on a phone. We need to make use of this opportunity to get this really seamless interaction going. When you first make it available on xCloud in the internal test environment, out of the box worked, right? We didn't have to do anything. And it worked fine. But it wasn't great, right? Because then you had this overlay where you had to press the virtual joystick to actually move a cursor around. That doesn't feel natural, right? So to us, it immediately clear, like, yeah, we want to do something better here. A lot of the UI, we made it slightly bigger, so it's easier to aim at the right option. And then the next stage is making an actual build for Xbox, and then giving that to more people, like the designers that are involved, to try out for themselves. If you would have to wait until it's actually put up into the xCloud environment, it's not a quick iteration time, but having the browser interface to get to the game really helps with that, and that makes the iteration time much faster. We make a build, we give it to the relevant people, they can play it with the streaming app or with the browser interface and feedback and make the changes where needed. We are not aiming just for hardcore gamers. We are aiming for anyone who is interested in good stories, right? People that normally sit together and watch Netflix that maybe get interested in this gaming aspect of it by it becoming interactive without being daunted by all the controls and the setup and everything that you have to do to be able to play it. We want to share these stories with as many people as possible, right? We want people to not be limited in playing the game at all. Be proud of our story, be proud of the thing we made. So we wanted to reach as many people as possible.